Medication can be a critical part of your blood sugar management and your overall health. But did you know that some types of pharmaceuticals can become problematic for you, potentially disrupting your glucose levels and your weight management? Certain drugs can even negatively interact with other diabetes medications or unintentionally increase your risk of diabetes-related complications. So, it's crucial that you understand the five most problematic types of medication for diabetics. First, a disclaimer. Prescribed pharmaceuticals, in general, should not be feared. And if your doctor believes that it is appropriate to start you on any of these medications, you should follow their advice. However, most any drug will carry certain side effects, and many can cause issues for your blood sugar control. Therefore, it is extremely important to have a basic understanding of the types of medicines you may one day require and the potential unwanted issues they may create for your body. So, let's start by discussing one of the most commonly prescribed medications on the market, statins. This one is tricky. That's because many diabetics are prescribed statins, and this medication can be extremely beneficial for your cardiovascular system. However, it can also come with risks. Statins are meant to lower the liver's production of LDL cholesterol, the type of cholesterol associated with clogged arteries. That's why this medication is often suggested to individuals who have already had a heart attack or those at risk of heart disease. And in fact, doctors regularly recommend that type 2 diabetics take statins. However, some studies now suggest that it can come with certain diabetes-related side effects. Namely, statins may slightly elevate your glucose levels, impair your insulin secretion, or modestly increase your levels of insulin resistance. In fact, meta-analyses of multiple studies have shown a small 9% increased risk of developing type 2 diabetes for those on high-dose statin therapy. Still, as this pharmaceutical has also been proven to aid cardiovascular health, especially for type 2 diabetics, most doctors agree that it is safe to use. However, it is strongly recommended that any statin therapy be closely regulated and monitored by your doctor. What other blood pressure-lowering medicine may lead to negative consequences for your blood sugar? That's coming up next. First, please do us a favor. If you find this video helpful, we'd love you to click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and we also want to hear your thoughts on medication side effects to watch out for, so comment below. Okay, next, let's get an understanding of a medicine you may already be taking if you suffer from arthritis or asthma. Corticosteroids. While steroids are associated with cheating athletes, this class of pharmaceuticals is actually extremely beneficial for many people and for a wide range of issues. Because they help to suppress the immune system, corticosteroids are prescribed to treat conditions like rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory bowel disease, and asthma. However, research now shows that chronic corticosteroid use can impair insulin secretion, potentially reducing insulin sensitivity. In fact, a study in the Archives of Bone and Joint Surgery found that taking corticosteroids, especially at high doses, can significantly raise blood glucose levels. And the American Journal of Medicine found that inhaled corticosteroid use was associated with a 34% increased risk in the development and progression of diabetes, with these risks becoming more pronounced at higher doses. That's why medical specialists recommend diabetic patients use corticosteroids cautiously, with careful monitoring of blood sugar levels. In some circumstances, prescription insulin or other glucose-lowering medications may need to be adjusted by your doctor in order to mitigate the hyperglycemic effects of this drug. Have you heard of or ever taken a diuretic medication? What does it do? And what are its diabetes-related side effects? That's just ahead. Now, we should investigate another common and important heart-helping drug that can carry some serious side effects. Beta blockers. It sure sounds like this medication, well, blocks your beta. But what does that mean? Beta blockers are meant to lower blood pressure, and are commonly prescribed to treat heart problems, including angina, heart rhythm issues, and heart failure. They are also used to lessen glaucoma, migraines, and even anxiety. However, research has linked this type of medication with an increased risk of developing diabetes. In fact, a meta-analysis of nearly 1,000 patients concluded that beta blocker therapy led to a 22% increased risk of becoming diabetic compared to other antihypertension medications. A report from the Journal of Clinical Hypertension shed more light on this subject by showing that traditional beta blockers can create adverse effects on carbohydrate and lipid metabolism, potentially increasing glucose intolerance, dyslipidemia, and insulin resistance. Still, this study noted that these effects are far less pronounced with newer forms of vasodilating beta blockers. Meanwhile, a more recent study further found that some types of beta blockers may mask some symptoms of hypoglycemia or dangerously low glucose levels. But this study also showed that for patients with hypoglycemic episodes, beta-1 selective beta blockers may potentially reduce the risk of death. Therefore, doctors now recommend specific types of this medication in the treatment of cardiovascular issues for type 2 diabetics. Just be sure to ask your doctor which exact beta blocker is best for aiding your heart health without negatively affecting your glucose control. Which extremely serious and necessary medication used by people all across the world can unintentionally increase your weight and heighten your blood pressure? Today's final medication is just ahead. First, if you suffer from hypertension, listen up. You may already be prescribed this drug. But let's look at the diabetes-related side effects for thiazide diuretics. This type of medication is one of the first pharmaceutical lines of defense against high blood pressure. Diuretics, sometimes called water pills, help the kidneys remove water and salt from the body through urine, which has the effect of reducing fluid in veins and arteries, thereby decreasing blood pressure. However, this means that taking a diuretic may lead to constipation. It also has the potential to cause dehydration, which is dangerous for everyone, especially those managing erratic glucose levels. Unfortunately, another potential side effect of thiazide diuretics is that they may impair glucose tolerance and insulin secretion, which can lead to hyperglycemia or high blood sugar levels. Plus, studies show that thiazide diuretics may unintentionally reduce potassium in the blood. This can be especially damaging for diabetics, as low potassium levels can impair insulin secretion from the pancreas, which can then lead to higher blood sugar levels. Chronic low potassium has also been shown to reduce insulin sensitivity. In fact, a study published in Current Diabetes Reports showed that thiazides are associated with an increased risk of developing diabetes. Other studies show that at higher doses, thiazide diuretics may increase fasting glucose and HbA1c levels in those who are already diabetic. Therefore, just be mindful about diuretics and ask your doctor if a thiazide diuretic is right or wrong for your body. Thank you for watching this important topic. We appreciate you sticking around. If you would like more free tips on battling back against high blood sugar, click the link in the description box below, and you will receive 3 amazingly helpful and, yes, totally free diabetes management guides, handcrafted by diabetes smarts. All right, we should mention one last serious and important medication which has been shown to carry some unfortunate side effects that may worsen your glucose control. So let's inspect. Antipsychotics. Antipsychotics are commonly prescribed for managing a variety of psychiatric disorders, and in many cases, these medications can be life-saving. However, their use in individuals with diabetes requires extra consideration, as studies show that they have the potential to create adverse effects on metabolic health. Specifically, many antipsychotics have been found to cause significant weight gain, This can heighten blood pressure and cholesterol levels, and it may potentially worsen glycemic control. Research also shows that antipsychotics have the ability to impair glucose metabolism directly, thereby leading to higher blood sugar levels. However, studies have further revealed that the diabetes risk of antipsychotics is greater with certain atypical medicines like clozapine and low-potency antipsychotics than with higher-potency antipsychotics like risperidone. Therefore, if your doctor deems it necessary to prescribe you this form of medicine, be sure to ask which types carry a lower risk of diabetes-related side effects. So, as you can see, there are several types of pharmaceuticals that may lead to unintended blood sugar consequences, including hyperglycemia, hypoglycemia, and heightened insulin resistance. But don't take this to mean that you should avoid any or all of these drugs outright. They are all FDA approved, and they have already helped millions of people to achieve better health. So, when it comes to drugs and diabetes management, it's all about crafting an appropriate and safe medication plan with your doctor.